Hi everyone, I'm Ellie and I'm your instructor for today and welcome to Code of the Future. Today we're just going to show you how to navigate around Visual Studio Code and how to set up the environment so it's perfect for you. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go straight into it and open up Visual Studio Code. So Visual Studio Code is actually very, very simple to navigate. This video is just going to tell you how to customize, you know, your own Visual Studio Code so that it looks good for you. So it'll come up with something like this. Now, if you want to get straight into coding, what we want to do is you want to click a new file, or what I like to do is open a folder. So the way that I quite like to do it is by opening a folder, and this essentially just makes life a little bit easier. So what I'm going to do is on my desktop, I've already done a video for PyCharm, so if you're interested in the setup for PyCharm, then check out that video. So that's why this folder's here, but I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm just going to call it VS Code. Okay. I'm just going to move it under PyCharm to make it look a little bit nicer. So we're going to move back onto Visual Studio Code. Now, Visual Studio Code, as I said, you can jump straight into things and start with a new file, which if you do that, it just creates a file. And, you know, it's untitled one, it's not named as anything, it's just a new file. What I quite like to do is as I've said, I've just crossed off that, is open a folder. Now, what that means is you can store everything you've done in that folder. And it means that when you start doing a bit more complicated code, like maybe incorporating a Python file from another file into one file, that sounds complicated, I know, it's a lot better to just have your folder. So we're just going to open a folder. So we want to go into desktop and we'll open VS Code here as we see. So we click open. It wants access to the desktop folder, which is absolutely fine because that's where the folder is located. So now what you'll notice is VS Code is up here. Obviously we have nothing in VS Code because the folder, as can be seen here, is completely empty. Now, I'm going to jump straight into showing you how you can change your font size and your style just so it's a bit easier for you to navigate. And obviously that's the essence of this video, is just getting a setup that's perfect for you. So we go into the top of here, we click Code, obviously that's Visual Studio Code. We click Preferences and then we go straight into Settings. So when this opens, you want to make sure you're in User, which is here, not Workspace, which obviously is there. You want to make sure you're in User, and then we're going to click on Text Editor. Now we have all these options here. So we go into Font. Now here, this is how we change the font size and everything. So obviously here, it must be written at the value of 6, because you would be straining your eyes slightly if that was the case. And we turn it back to 16. Okay, so we've changed it to 16, and a pop-up just came up down there that said your changes are automatically applied. So we've changed it to size 16, which I think is what we did for the PyCharm. So obviously we've changed that now. We're in Settings up here. We can just cross off Settings. So what that's done is it's changed the font size. Now that just means that when you start to code, when you load a Python file into here and you start coding, the font size will be 16. Which is great, and obviously that means that you can see a little bit better when you start coding. So essentially what I'm going to do now is just show you how you can change the setup. So we're going to go back into code, we're going to go to preferences, and we're going to go down to color theme. Now these are all the themes that you can choose. So here are the light themes, which means if I was to just click onto that, it suddenly goes bright. And that's quite funny because the sun has just also come out as I've done that. Strange. You know, you can go back into preferences, color theme, you can change them again. We can go to high contrast, which is what I did in PyCharm, and that surprised me slightly when I looked at it, because it was quite it looked a bit better in PyCharm actually. So we're just going back into preferences. Now I quite like the dark theme, but if I'm honest, these are also pretty nice as well. Just that, you know, you've got quiet light. I often opt for the darker just because sometimes you can get headaches from staring at bright screens so often. Obviously the only thing is then you just have to increase your brightness, which is fine, until the sun starts glaring at you like it is today and you struggle to see a little bit. But it's just better for, you know, if you're staring at a computer for a long period of time, I prefer the darker one. But as I say, you can go for the lighter one or choose any one you want. Which again is just done by going code, preferences, color theme, and you opt the one you want. So there we've shown you how you can change the colour theme and also the font size. I'll just show you how the font size works when I start opening up some files. So here we have the VS Code, which is our folder here. And obviously, as we see, there's nothing in this folder. I'm just going to go back. And obviously, as you see here, there's nothing in the folder. So this means, okay, let's open a file, let's start coding, as it were. Obviously, I'm not going to do any coding in this video just because we're showing you the setup. That will be in the later videos. So what we want to do is, we've got this folder here, we don't have any files, we want to create a file. One option is to click new file, and you can type in exactly what you want. So we're just going to put file one. Now, what I'm going to say about this now is that if you save it as file one, it will save it as a pure text file. And what that means is it's not saved as a Python file or anything like that, which means when you go to run this file, it won't recognize that it's a Python file. It's very similar to if you were to type .pdf for a PDF or .doc for a document. I think even now, files on computers, if you were to get rid of the .doc after a document, it doesn't let you because it means it can't read it. That, in essence, this is the same for Python files and all other programming files. So the way that you create a Python file is you just put .py at the end of it. Now what you'll notice here is when you got rid of it, here we have little lines, so it's a text file. When you click .py, sorry, not when you click, when you type .py, it changed to the Python file logo, which is how you know it is a Python file. So that is how you do Python. You don't want to put .python because that obviously, as you see, it's not right. It has to be .py. So when you click enter, that is now the Python file. Down here it says, do you want to install the recommended extensions for Python? You can click install. I would click install, but for now I'm just showing you the setup. So I'm just going to cross off that for now. But if you will be using Visual Studio Code, then you can click install on that. So as you can see here, the font is actually pretty big. So let's just put high. So that's what I mean about the font style being different. Obviously, high does not work in a Python file, but you'll understand that later when I go into the coding aspects of things. But I'm just going to put high for now and show you that when I then go back into preferences and go back into settings and I change this to, oh, I don't know, 25, it will automatically have saved. So when you go into Python file, that is massive. You can make it even bigger. I think for the ease of this video, I'm probably just going to stick with 25 because it's pretty big and you can see it a lot better than you probably would do if it was on 16. So here we are. So, you know, I can't really write hi because that doesn't really do anything in Python, which you will learn later on. So in essence, what we've managed to do is create a folder, VS Code, which is what we called it, and just add a file. So we've added a file into this folder, and as you can see, when I click onto VS Code here, the Python file is there, which is perfect. So in today's video, we've managed to create a folder, VS Code, and input a Python file into it. Obviously, the Python file is empty, but we haven't learned to code just yet. Again, we've touched upon the font size, it's changed, and also how you can change the setup as well, so the colour and everything in Visual Studio Code. So all the Python videos on my channel will be done through PyCharm, just because I absolutely love PyCharm. But when I move on to the web development videos, I will be doing them in Visual Studio Code. So you may be watching this later on, after I've told you to come back here if you want to learn how to do web development. But for now, this is just a basic overview of how to get a nice setup for Visual Studio Code. If you did like the video, then please like, subscribe, and comment, and I will see you all in the next video.